The Path of Legends is one of the most important ones in the game as it allows your boring legendary Pokemon to start acquiring new forms in the game to help enhance your travel. This is why you must do these in order to explore the whole map, and you can make those boring legendary Pokemon good. On the map here are all the Titans. By the way, you can fight these Titans in whatever order you want. I'm going to be going in order of the ones at certain difficulty and giving you the average level range that you should be when you're going to go ahead and challenge them, so you don't just walk up to one and get completely nuked and your team gets destroyed. Let's talk about the first one, the Stony Cliff Titan Klawf. Klawf is a rock type, which means rock types are effective against fire, ice, flying, and bug. So in order to combat rock, you're going to need the following Pokemon: water, grass, fighting, ground, or steel. Water Pokemon, you could use Quaxly or Wigglet. For grass Pokemon, you could use Sprigatito, Breloom, or Shroomish, or even Go-Goat. For fighting Pokemon, you can use Riolu or Lucario. For ground Pokemon, you can use Paldean Wooper. This Pokemon can shine here because it is a ground type and it also is a poison type. And for steel Pokemon, a great one to use is Tinkaton. This one is so good. I love this Pokemon. That hammer is amazing. All right, so Klawf will be using rocket types against you. And with these Pokemon of those typings, it should be a really easy nuke to it. Now, all these Titan Pokemon, once you defeat them, are going to have a second encounter again once they eat this Herba Mystica and power up. Luckily, the second fight feels a little more easier, even though they power it up, because Arvin comes to help you. So you should have no problem on the second round. Please make sure to heal up before any of the second encounters you have with any of these Titans. That is the best time to do it. Heal up, get your PP up, and you should be good to go. Once you finally defeat Klawf, you'll be able to unlock Dash after beating this. Now, Dash allows your Pokemon to travel really fast, and you have the ability to bump into trees and get some secret Pokemon that may be in there. Speaking of Dash, you should also hit that subscribe button to help Miraidon dash and catch all these dragon Pokemon. The next Titan that we'll be talking about is the Open Sky Titan Bombirdier. The average level to approach this Titan is going to probably be about 18 to 20. If you're in that range, you're in a pretty good range to fight this. Obviously, if you're above the level, you can destroy this Titan. But if you're really low, don't go ahead and fight Bombirdier. A good Pokemon to use against this because it is a dark flying type are electric, ice, rock, and fairy. You want to avoid using fighting types, flying types, or bug types because of its flying. You don't want to use ghost because it has dark attacks. Psychic literally cannot hit dark, and ground types don't really do any damage against flying Pokemon. So stick with the electric, ice, rock, or fairy types because they would be doing a phenomenal job. Great electric Pokemon to use against us are Waterroll or its evolution, Kilowatterroll, and Bellybulb. These are great electric Pokemon options. Ice Pokemon can include Titan or Frigvax, which is a ice pseudo legendary Pokemon that you can find in this game. A rock Pokemon that you can use are Rockruff or Lycanroc. It doesn't matter which form of Lycanroc. It's just really great to have those Pokemon really early in the game, and there's Rockruffs everywhere and it's a rock dog. Why not use it? For fairy typing, you can either use Tinkaton and you could maybe also use Gardevoir. Bombirdier is probably one of the coolest fights because you literally have to climb uphill while it's throwing rocks at you down this giant path. I think this was actually the most interactive Titan fight, and I wish the other Titans were like this, but it was really cool to see, and hopefully in the future we can implement more things happening in the environment just like this one. Once you are able to complete this and you fight the second time with Arvin, you'll be able to unlock Swim on your legendary Pokemon, or your Koraidon or Miraidon. Swimming is really good because it is able to give you access to start swimming in that lake all the way north of the map in order for you to eventually get to the final Titan, but we'll get to that as we keep on going. The next Titan is the Lurking Steel Titan known as Orthworm. This is going to be ranging about level 28 to 30, so if you're in that range, you're in a very good spot to fight it. Now, Orthworm is a complete mono steel type, and it is effective against ice, rock, and fairies. The types that are really good to use against steel type Pokemon are fire, fighting, ground, but Orthworm has access to rock moves and ground moves, so you probably don't want to be using a fire typing against it. So I highly suggest that you stick with fighting or ground unless you have a fire type Pokemon that can hit really hard and just take it out in a couple shots and maybe survive rock attacks or earth attacks. If you're going to use fire Pokemon, I suggest Talonflame, a Cerulege, Armorouge, or the fire starter to hit really hard. This will be great for the fight, but Pokemon like Quaxly, because it is a water fighting type, so you can probably do some good damage on this. Another fighting type, you could use Gallade. Hariyama is another great option as well. And our favorite Pokemon everyone loves to hear about, Paldean Wooper. Again, being ground typing or its evolution, Claude Sire, being ground typing, it has a huge advantage and can do a lot of damage against steel because steel is weak to it. And you can see Chaldean Whooper is pretty much a very good staple to have on your team. Once you defeat Orthworm, it's just gonna roam around the map, finally go into a little cave, break it open, eat its Herba Mystica, Arfin helps you fight it again. And once you defeat it, you're going to have access to jumping. Your mounts will now jump higher. So now you've unlocked jumping, you've unlocked swimming, and you've unlocked dashing. We're not even done. Now, this next Pokemon is split into two versions. I'll be covering the Scarlet version, and then I'll be covering the Violet version, and you can decide amongst yourselves in the comments which one is actually more difficult. The level range for this next Titan Pokemon is about level 43 to 45. If you're in that range, you can probably handle these Titans. This one refers to the Quaking Earth Titan, the Great Tusk, which is exclusive to Scarlet. This one is when you start to really feel the power of the Titans, because I accidentally wandered into this area thinking, oh, I've beaten the other Titans, let's go ahead and fight this one. And if you come too early to this Titan, it might teach you a lesson. But if you're those bold Pokemon players that think you can take this down, that'll be amazing if you can. And please share a strategy below if you were able to do that. The Great Tusk is a ground fighting type, which means its weaknesses are water, grass, ice, flying, psychic, and fairy Pokemon. Those can all do some good damage on it. But these types of moves are better than actually being that typing, because the Great Tusk has a lot of coverage. It has access to fighting moves, which can wreck ice types, and it has knockoff, which can wreck psychic types. So Pokemon that you probably want to use here are water fighting types, like Quaxly's final evolution, Quaquavla. You want to use Arbeliva, which is the final evolution of Smoliv. Dondozo is not a bad option. It's a very bulky water type Pokemon. Paladin, very good dolphin evolution. It has a very high base attack. Even a flying fighting type like Flamigo can do some work on this boss. Also, Gardevoir is a great choice if you want to use that as well. Once you're able to finally destroy this big fight for the first time, you're going to do another rematch with it, team up with Arvin. You're going to beat it. But the best part about this one is you finally will have access to gliding with your Pokemon. Remember, gliding just allows you to go from top to bottom, not from bottom to up. So you'll always be constantly going down when you're gliding. So keep that in mind, that it's not an infinite flying up. So we're calling this glide, not fly. If you're playing Pokemon Violet, you're gonna have to deal with Iron Treads, which is pretty much a ground steel Pokemon. For this fight, you're gonna want to use fighting, water, or ground, and not fire because of the ground moves it has. Good fighting types include Flamigo, Quaquavo, fighting water Tauros, great option to also use because you are in Pokemon Violet, you guys have access to this Pokemon, and Paladin. These Pokemon should be able to carry you through this fight with no problem, and once you defeat the futuristic Dawn fan named Iron Treads, you should also be able to get gliding. So Pokemon Violet players actually might have it a lot easier than Pokemon Scarlet. Let me know which one you think is more difficult. This is the highest level Titan out of all the Pokemon in the game. You need to be about an average level of 52 to 53 to go ahead and take this on without having any crazy problems. Again, if you want more of a challenge, you can be under that level and go ahead and face this Pokemon. This one is going to be Dondozo, which is a water type Pokemon, extremely bulky on the defense side. So if you're going to hit it, you're going to have to use a special attacker to fight it off. Dondozo is going to have access to water moves, dragon moves, and it does a lot of body slamming on you that would probably end up paralyzing you. So Pokemon that you want to bring to this are electric and grass, because it's very simple, right? That's all you're thinking at first. Electric, grass, easy wipe. Great grass Pokemon that you could use against Dondozo include Bramblin, Meowscarada, and Arbeliva. If you're going to be using electric types against this Pokemon, I suggest maybe Belly Ball, Raichu, or Magnezone. Once you're able to defeat this Pokemon for the first time, it should be pretty easy. It's then going to have its second rematch with you powered up. You're going to do the duo battle, beat it, and then a surprise at the end. Something comes out of its mouth, and you realize that the real Titan all along was Tatsugiri. And this is a water dragon Pokemon. Think of Walmart Palkia. Unfortunately for anyone who has brought grass Pokemon or electric Pokemon to the fight, Tatsugiri is going to have ground moves and is going to have ice moves. The ground moves will be taking out your electric Pokemon, and the ice moves will be taking out your grass Pokemon. So make sure you pull out your fairy Pokemon for this fight so you can easily take down this dragon in one shot, allowing you to finally have access to climbing, which is one of the most OP abilities in the game that your legendary can do. And you have the ability to go anywhere you want in the game, climb the highest of highest areas, and discover all the secrets on the map. So you beat all the Titan Pokemon, but you haven't beaten everything in the game yet, go ahead and check out this video to see how you can beat all the Team Star members and the best Pokemon to bring there.